感谢主持人把第一个提问机会给了我。王部长您好，我是人民日报记者、人民网记者。2013年是中国新一届政府的外交开局之年，作为外长，这一年的外交工作给您留下印象最深刻的是什么？您能否和我们分享一下呢？2014年中国外交该怎样进行？请您给我们讲一讲，谢谢。
People's Daily and its website. I appreciate the first opportunity to ask you questions, Minister Wang. 2013 was the first year of diplomacy under the new Chinese government. As China's foreign minister, what has struck you the most about China's diplomacy in the past year? And could you also talk about how China will pursue its diplomacy in 2014?
去年中国外交最鲜明的特点就是主动进取。
Active is the most salient feature of China's diplomacy in the past year.
以习近平同志为总书记的党中央，顺应人民群众的愿望和国际社会的期待，开展了一系列有声有色的外交活动。有一组数据和大家分享。习近平主席、李克强总理密集出访了22个国家，接待了65位外国元首和政府首脑访华，同300多位外国政要进行会见交流，与外国达成了约800项合作协议。还有一组事实啊，要告诉大家，一年来我们有力地维护了领土主权和海洋权益，推进了与主要大国的关系，提出了一路一带等一系列重大的合作倡议，在叙利亚、伊朗等热点问题的政治解决方面，我们发挥了建设性的作用。我们还首次派出了成建制的安全部队赴马里维和，还首次在实战状态下派军舰为叙利亚化学武器的运送提供护航。
The CPC Central Committee, headed by General Secretary Xi Jinping, responded to the aspirations of the people and the expectations of the international community, and carried out a series of visible and effective diplomatic activities.Let me share some figures with you. President Xi Jinping and Premier Li Keqiang visited as many as 22 countries, received 65 foreign heads of state and government, met and talked with over 300 foreign dignitaries, and reached around 800 cooperation agreements with other countries. There are also some facts I'd like to share with you. In the past year, China vigorously defended its territorial sovereignty.And maritime rights and interests, advanced relations with major countries, unveiled a series of major cooperation initiatives, such as the Silk Road Economic Belt and the 21st Century Maritime Silk Road. And we played a constructive role in the political settlement of hotspots issues, such as Syria and Iran. For the first time, we sent formed units of our security force.To a UN peacekeeping mission in Mali, and for the first time, we sent a naval vessel under operational conditions to escort shipments of Syrian chemical weapons.
2013年的中国外交展示出更宽阔视野、更积极作为，不仅是成功的开局之年，也是创新之年、丰收之年。
China's diplomacy in 2013 was broader in horizon and more active in conduct. It was not just a successful year under the new leadership. It was also a year of innovation and harvest for China's diplomacy.
2014年，中国外交将继续积极进取，重点从两个方向做出努力。
In 2014, China will continue to pursue an active foreign policy and we will focus our efforts on two main areas.
一是要更加积极主动地服务于国内全面深化改革。我们将加强同世界各国，尤其是周边国家的友好关系，为国内改革发展营造更为良好的外部环境。我们将大力开展经济外交，深化与各国互利合作，为国内经济转型升级提供更为良好的条件。我们还将全力推进海外民生工程，为中国不断对外延伸的正当权益提供更坚实的保障。
First, we'll be more active in serving the efforts to comprehensively deepen reform in China. We'll strengthen friendly relations with all countries in the world, especially our neighbors. And we will create a more enabling external environment for domestic reform and development. We'll vigorously pursue economic diplomacy, deepen win-win cooperation with other countries, and create a more favorable condition for the transformation and upgrading of China's economy. And we will do all we can to implement the initiative to better protect and serve overseas Chinese and provide stronger protection for China's ever-growing legitimate rights and interests.
第二个方向是更加积极主动地发挥负责任的大国作用。我们将在国际交往中主持公道，伸张正义，践行平等，尤其是维护和促进广大发展中国家的正当的权益，推动国际秩序向着更加公正、合理的方向发展。我们还将积极地参与国际和地区事务，为解决各种全球性的问题和地区热点问题，提出更多中国方案，发挥更大中国作用。
Secondly, we'll be more active in playing the role of a responsible big country. In our international engagement, we will uphold principles, promote justice, and practice equality. In particular, we will protect and advance the legitimate rights and interests of developing countries and make the international order more just and equitable. And we will take an active part in international and regional affairs.And put forward more Chinese proposals and play a bigger role in helping to resolve all kinds of global issues and regional hotspot issues.